Mr. Reid, thanks very much for your time. Now, we've heard there about the complicated paperwork, and most of us have seen footage of empty supermarket shelves in Northern Ireland. What we don't seem to see, though, is evidence of lorries backed up at ports like Cairnryan. So can you tell us more about the problems?
Yeah, essentially what's happening is that there's an entire supply chain having to relearn how to do things. So a lot of products that would normally be moving are not moving because the clients are unsure of what paperwork that they need to do, what their customs requirements are. And in some cases, hauliers are not picking up the goods because they're not confident that when they get to the port, the customer has produced the right numbers. So, yeah, a lot of goods are effectively stranded within the system and are not moving the way they should do.
Right, now these problems were expected, weren't they? So what can be done about it?
Well, when we say these problems were expected, we did warn, we have been warning the government for the last 3 or 4 years. But the issue, the main issue that's come is the fact that the systems only went live a couple of days before the, you know, the 1st of January, which was when things all changed. So nobody within the supply chain has had the time to look at things, to plan things, to play about with the systems and make sure that their business model works with what the new customs requirements are. So that's where the major problem has arisen.
What kind of stresses are your hauliers telling you that they're under?
Financial stresses, more than anything else. You mentioned Northern Ireland earlier on, and yes, there are some empty shelves there. Northern Ireland has had issues with the systems, but also the main problem that they have now is when the goods are getting from Northern Ireland to the UK, there are very few backloads coming. So when a haulier prices a job, then they're pricing it on the reliance that they will be bringing goods, paid goods back to Northern Ireland. Now those journeys have all but disappeared. And so hauliers are running empty on the way back in a lot of cases.
So what can be done? I mean, what engagement is the Road Hauliers Association having with the UK government over this?
We are having daily contact with the government. Our chief executive, Richard Burnett, is dealing with Michael Gove on a one-to-one basis, and it's virtually every day. We're listening to the hauliers, and we're trying to put the hauliers in front of the government so that they can hear these opinions and these problems firsthand. The problems are not going to go anytime soon. So, I mean, realistically, what we want is what we should have had in the first place, which is an easement so that there is a period of time where everybody can get used to the system, so the system can bed in and people can use their or adapt their working models to what's now required. Because at the minute, the supply chain is all but shut down, essentially, for Northern Ireland.
So basically, we're relying on things getting better as soon as possible, at least in the next few months.
We need things to happen a long time before that, because a lot of the hauliers will not be in business if the problems last another few days rather than another few months. It's become that critical.
OK. Martin Reid, thank you very much for your time. I know it's a busy one for you. Thank you.
Thank you.